Hey David, this is David Kwon, and I know I'm talking to you, my 14-year-old self. So me, when I was 14, I guess you are still really invested in playing the violin. Even when when you were in New York as 10-year-old kid, you still ended up being in this school orchestra, and you played your violin, and you take lessons now every week. You have this really awesome violin teacher, and you're gonna stay under her wing until you're pretty much 18 years old and ready to go to college. Unfortunately, you do ask the question, do I at least play until college? Yeah, you do actually. You play the violin up until college, and then you go to college and then you kind of stop playing. So it's the relationship you have with the violin is kind of, I don't know, it's an extra thing. Violin never becomes a big part of your life, never becomes a big part of my life. Unfortunately, it is one of those things that's kind of just really extra. You're not horrible at it, but you never become really confident in it and be able to say, like, I'm really good at this thing, so I should really have this passion for it. You never get to that level. But it is something that you really enjoy doing. You 14 years old. Oh yeah, this is after you broke your arm. That's right. So you've already gone through the struggle. That's right. Of breaking your right arm, which was such a hard thing to get used to play the violin, because it uses the arm and learning the vibrato. It was a hard struggle, but you struggled through it because you still had that great passion about the violin. The violin takes you, gives you great life experiences, I think. I can't really think about the violin in a negative light. The only thing I'm really disappointed is that I don't have the capacity, or I don't have the confidence in my capacity to go far with the violin. That's probably the biggest problem with me and the violin. But it does take you to really great many places. You do a bunch of different school orchestras. You end up fostering this really awesome friendship with this girl, and you do like a recital. She plays the piano. You play the violin, and that's pretty awesome. You end up volunteering at one of the local hospitals, in which you play the violin for patients who've undergone surgery. So that's something that you do as a volunteer experience for while you're in high school. And of course you're pretty devoted Christian for a long time in your life. That the spoiler alert is that you kind of, okay, let's not talk about that. But yeah, and in churches and stuff, you play the violin in church. Music is kind of, creating music is also a part of you. Really great thing is that violin is not the only instrument that you can end up, you end up learning to play. You can improvise with the piano. You're not really good at reading sheet music and playing the piano with that sheet music. You're kind of horrible at that. You could do that with the violin really easily, but that's something you can't really do with the piano for some reason, because you never really grow to like the piano all that much, other than to just play whatever, kind of play by ear. You like to improvise on piano, and as long as you play in A major and C major, you're pretty good at it, kind of. Sort of. And then you end up, picking up guitar. You can play a bunch of chords, you can play, Christian praise songs. So you end up actually being part of different youth groups and, playing praise songs in front of an audience, the church audience. So that's a great big fun. So in a way, music, you do have this kind of, I want to say, short love affair, with music, with creating music, and with playing instruments. But in the overall picture of your life, it's kind of short-lived. It's really not that important, although at certain points in your life, you do feel like it should be important. But it's one of those things where you kind of start lacking more and more, lacking confidence in it. So you kind of just give up. I think the one thing that really holds you to keep on playing the violin as long as you can is your violin teacher. She's really awesome, and you develop this awesome friendship with her. and she's kind of the reason that you play, and then you go to college and you don't really meet her anymore, so that's why you kind of give up on playing. But it's not something you give up entirely. I mean, I still go back home to Tennessee and I still play a couple of times. There's this recent volunteer opportunity in which I'm probably going to end up using my violin playing skills. So it's something that you'll always have, but it just never becomes a big part of your life, and you come to accept that fact. So, cheers.